Ladies and gentlemen, this is Ringside Chaos, the greatest professional wrestling podcast in the history of the world. It's also the pro wrestling discussions segment of the Bear of Texas podcast and Paint Drain Pipe Bomb Productions. You all know who I am, so allow me to welcome back Brooklyn's finest, ladies and gentlemen, Mark freaking Braverman. And Brav, I know that you are ready to discuss and preview the Royal Rumble.
Absolutely, I'm more than ready to preview the Royal Rumble, but I want to get something out of the way first. And that is, the last time I was on this show, I made a terrible mistake when we talked about the Survivor Series and War Games. And I want to apologize to all the performers that were involved in that match. It did not take place in 1999. It took place in 1998, which was pointed out to a friend of mine. So I apologize to our viewers. Alex, I apologize to you because we are professional on this show. But once in a while, we do make a little bit of a goof, and I made a big one. So I am sorry.
Well, I accept your apology. And honestly, no apology was necessary because, look, we all make these mistakes. I've even seen wrestlers themselves make these kinds of mistakes as well. So there's nothing to be ashamed of, Mark. I mean, you really didn't do anything wrong. You made a mistake, and you know what? The only thing that proves is that you're human. And if somebody had made a bad comment about saying, hey, your guest got this wrong, he's an idiot, I would have said, yeah, he's an idiot because he makes one little mistake like that. But, you know, but yeah, you're good, man. But as we start the preview, I got to tell you, the last couple of Royal Rumbles, we've not been pretty happy, especially what happened in 2022.
Let's not go there.
Yeah, I mean, you were pissed. And our friend Ricky, our friend Ricky was fuming.
Oh, yeah. Well, 2022 was terrible. I mean, you want to talk about two people absolutely did not deserve or need to win. And then last year, I wasn't happy either, but, you know, I was happy that Cody won.
Yeah.
But I wasn't happy with the result, what happened at WrestleMania. Nobody was. And
yeah,
I honestly was pulling for the Liv or Bayley last year and wound up being Rhea, but it turned out actually Breezeman had been doing some of her best work since she won the Rumble. So,
yeah.
Not happy with the result, but at the same time, I'm happy what they're building with her now.
All right. Well, before we get into the Royal Rumble, we do need to talk about Seth Rollins. And, you know, we were actually supposed to record this on Monday, but because of the whole thing with the injury, because there was the news that he would address it, we had to actually wait, because we had to wait to see what he had to say.
Yeah, and the simple fact is, I'm going to put this out right now. I've torn every part of my knee you can imagine, the meniscus, the ACL, I've torn it all. And I'm very concerned with the fact that Seth Rollins holding off his surgery. I've torn on both my knees. I've torn meniscus in both my knees. It's very, very painful. I played hockey with it torn, which was my huge mistake, and I'm paying for it now, 20-some-odd years later. I can tell you that it's very, very painful. This is not an easy injury to recover with. And I think that the doctors are letting him perform is nuts and crazy. I think he needs to get the surgery now before the pain and the injury gets worse.
Because this is the same knee which he destroyed back in 2015.
Yeah, and he also destroyed the Ring of Honor. So he's got to be very, very careful with this one.
Dude, he's been having knee problems for years. I think also with his back and his shoulders. I mean, the dude's body is just battered, man. But that's pro wrestling for you. So once again, everybody out there that likes to make a joke out of this, shove it up your ass, man, because this is not fake, okay? It's wrong to call it fake. There's nothing fake about it. It's scripted, but it's dangerous, man. If you want to call pro wrestling fake, well, you know what? Those Hollywood movies that you love so much, yeah, those are fake. Yeah.
The injuries are so real here.
Yeah.
I mean, look what happened to Bayley a couple years ago. She was out almost longer than a year because of her knee.
And if you had wrestlers die in the ring too.
Sure. May Owen Hart rest in peace. May. Huh? Okay. But you're talking about a very bad injury. And if you watch Bayley wrestle sometimes, even she's limping around on that bad leg. So why the WWE's I know Seth Rollins is popular. I know he's the best champion right now in all professional wrestling. No offense to all the other guys working on belts. But at the same time, he has to be careful.
He has to.
Has to be careful, and honestly, as a fan of the guy who's been since he's been known as Tyler Black, walking around with this kind of an injury and getting into the ring with this kind of injury is not a good idea.
It's not. So from what I understand, yep, the confirmation is a grade 2 MCL tear along with a torn meniscus. And yes, according to a source, the time to recover from this is actually 3 to 4 months minimum.
No way. It's more than that. Trust me, I've been through it. It's a lot more than that. You're talking, if it's three to four months, then you start walking.
Okay.
But the pain and getting back into the gym and getting back to the ring physically, more than that. Look what happened to Bailey. Bailey was out over a year.
Yeah.
So Liv Morgan is still out.
Mm-hmm.
Look at the Queen. She's out for months. She's out till God.
I know. Yeah. But Rollins delivered a massive promo, which I'm not surprised because that's what Rollins does, whether he's a face or a heel. Promises, and I quote, "I will take this title to WrestleMania," unquote. You know, mentions that he's not going to miss the show. He doesn't care what the doctors say. I mean, this is typical baby face, you know, stuff like that. So, yeah, massive promo. And, you know, of course, he even got emotional, which I'm sure was legitimate. He was not acting that. So the only thing I was surprised, though, I didn't expect Gunther to interrupt him. I kind of expected Jinder Mahal to do that.
I was about to say the same thing. If that Gunther come out or anybody come out when he's doing this is dumb. I would have Becky Lynch come out and tell him, "Look, you're my husband. Are you sure you want to be doing this?"
Yeah. You know what? Yeah, Becky Lynch would have been also somebody else I would have expected to come out.
Right, because Becky had this kind of an injury once before. It put her out for months, though.
Yeah. So now, no disrespect to Gunther. I mean, Gunther, you know, what he did, the promo, Gunther did a good job. I'm just saying, I just never would have expected it to be Gunther.
It never made it to me. I was watching this with my wife. And I said to my wife, why would they send out Gunther? It doesn't make sense. It was inappropriate for that to have Gunther come out at a time where a guy is saying, "I'm injured, I don't know if I can go, I'm gonna say the hell with the doctors," to have him come out, totally dumb. Didn't like it. And that's just me. Anyway. We wish Seth Rollins all the best of luck on the show. So let's talk about the Rumble, shall we?
Last thing I want to say is I would imagine Rollins is going to drop the belt and he's going to have surgery after WrestleMania. That's probably the way I see it now.
I think he should have it now.
I mean, again, I mean, in your case, you've had the injuries, so I mean, I can't argue your point.
Both knees at least two times.
Yeah. So, yeah, I'm ready to go the Royal Rumble. So. And I understand that you want to give a little, you want to go through a little bit of history lessons as we progress through. Am I correct?
Yes, I do.
All right. So let me ask you, which Royal Rumble is your favorite and why?
I have a couple of them. 2001, Stone Cold Steve Austin wins the Rumble, which was just an amazing Rumble because Kane threw out like 12, 13 guys. You had the hardcore stuff at one point, which was fantastic. The Dudleys beat Edge and Christian, one of the greatest tag matches of all time. And in my opinion, one of the greatest ladder matches of all time happened, Jericho versus Benoit, which was just a 5-star classic. That, except for the, I hate to say it because the heavyweight title match wasn't that great, Triple H versus Angle, they could have done a lot better. But that Royal Rumble was just fantastic. 1991, except for the title match, also a good Rumble. And of course, everybody's favorite on the list, 1992, Ric Flair draws number 3, goes all the way and wins the whole thing.
And delivers one of the greatest promos ever.
Right. Plus, Piper won the Intercontinental title. He had some great matches on the card. So those are the ones that have always been my favorites. Always loved them.
All right.
So we have a couple of repeat winners to talk about. We all know about Stone Cold Steve Austin. 1 of 3.
Uh-huh.
Hogan won it twice. 1990, 1991. Triple H won it twice. 02 and 216 when he won the... In 2016, he took the title. Lesnar, 03 and 22. We don't talk about that. And Edge won it 21, and I believe in 2010 he won it. So
yep, it was 2010, yeah.
We also have a couple people won it number 1 and won it number 30, but we'll get to that later.
Right. So,
where do you want to start? The matches, or you want to go right to the Rumbles themselves?
Well, as I'm looking at the card, I mean...
Is the card
even completed at this point?
The card is a little thin, yes.
Yeah, because the Rumble is just a few days away.
We don't know who Rhea is going to face.
Right.
We know Seth is not wrestling for obvious reasons, so he ain't going.
All right.
We got this ridiculous four corners match, which...
Well, we all know who's going to win that one.
Yeah, let's talk about this for a second. And honestly, we know it's going to be Roman Reigns.
Right.
But I just don't like the guy with the belt. I honestly don't. He never defends the title. He's a horrible champion. I just don't like him. I've never have liked Roman Reigns. I don't like him when he was in ROH. I don't like him now. But that's me. I think that his run is boring. In 3 years, he's only defended the belt. But maybe not even every pay-per-view he defends the belt.
And I think the one title defense that we actually enjoyed, but it was ruined at the end, was in the Royal Rumble 2 years ago against Seth Rollins.
Yes.
The match was great, but the ending just ruined it.
First of all, Seth Rollins should have won number one. And number two, yeah, the ending was just terrible. We've agreed on that for a long time.
I just love how Seth Rollins came out in the Shield gear just to get in Roman Reigns' head. So, I mean, that's what's one thing that made it so special. But we look at this four corners match. I mean, it's called a Fatal Four Way, but I prefer to call it a four way dance. I like to put a little ECW to it because that's really what it's better. It's better than saying Fatal Four Way. That's my opinion. We got Roman Reigns versus Orton versus AJ Styles versus LA Knight.
You're talking about three very, very talented men going after that belt.
Oh, yeah.
So you're talking about three of WWE's top drawers going after that title. But the problem is we know Roman's walking out because everybody's assuming this year the WWE is going to get it right and he loses at WrestleMania. He should have lost it last year to Cody Rhodes. It would have been a lot easier for WWE, but mistakes are made and whatever. I do think Roman's winning it, but I think that he's gonna take a beating in this match.
Once
can he win a match clean? Can he please win a match clean without the Walrus or anybody else in the damn bloodline getting involved? I know he's heel.
The Walrus.
Even heel Triple H has won. Even when heel Triple H one match is clean. Heel Taker, one match is clean. Win a match clean? Yeah, absolutely. Dean Ambrose. Brock Lesnar. The list goes on and on. Can this man, for once in his life, win a clean match? Win the match clean, I mean? Is it possible?
I would only hope so.
Proving why he's a terrible champion? Hell, even Hogan, when he was in the NWO, and I hate the NWO. Even Hogan won a couple of matches clean when he was at the NWO.
Right.
Look at Ric Flair. How many times when he was in the Four Horsemen did he win a clean match as a heel?
I don't remember seeing much of that, but yeah, I mean, he won a few times clean, but of course, you know, the heel, you know, the dirt. He's the dirtiest player in the game, so obviously.
He is, so. But he's also, a lot of times with the Horsemen, you stay here. I've got this. So it's time. Let him win something clean.
I mean, this year, it's time for him to drop the belts, really.
It's been time. Really it's has. Been time.
But, so I got Roman Reigns winning, obviously, but that question is, who does Roman Reigns pin, and what's going to happen during the match? Are we going to see, like, some tensions between Styles and Orton?
Well, we know somebody's going to break up a couple hundred pins. We know that's going to happen. And we know eventually they're going to get knocked out of the ring, or someone's going to get knocked out, or someone's going to go through a table, or someone's going to get by a chair, or the Walrus and his three or four boy toys are going to get involved, and we all know that's going to happen. And eventually it comes a stupid spear and, you know. But I think LA Knight gets pinned.
You know what? I think so too, yeah.
Orton's too strong to get pinned, and so is AJ Styles. So I think that LA Knight is going to get pinned.
Which is going to make a lot of people mad.
It will, but he's the obvious choice.
Right. Or maybe
Styles.
Because if the match ends in a no contest, why not? Like if the bloodline gets involved and then... whatever.
Yeah. Not that it's young.
It's, yeah. So obviously I got the Tribal Chief winning.
We both do.
Yeah. But yeah, I think LA Knight being pinned is, I mean, that's the most realistic way I could see it. Yeah, I feel like we should have gotten this is the match we probably should have talked about first. Logan Paul versus Kevin Owens for the United States Championship.
It has potential to be a decent match, but honestly, I think this might also be the weak link on the card. I really do.
Sad too, because I love Kevin Owens, and I have no issue with Logan Paul, really.
I have been a Kevin Owens fan since he was known as Kevin Cena, running around with a guy named El Generico in a lonely company called Ring of Honor.
You're a Ring of Honor original.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
That's how long I've been following his career. Same thing with El Generico, a.k.a. Sami Zayn. But Logan Paul does not impress me.
Okay.
Now, I know I'm going to take a beating for this, but he does not impress me. So I think that Kevin Steens is going to win the match, honestly. I think he has to win the match. But this could – the chemistry is just not there. I don't see the chemistry with these two guys. And to lower Kevin Steen down to – or Kevin Owens down to the mid-card just makes me angry. He needs to get into the title picture.
I want to see him be the heel that he was from 2014 to like 2016. I want to see Kevin Owens be that big, massive, hated heel that we all know he can be. I mean, he's a great babyface as well. He can even be a better babyface than he is now, but I think we all love the heel, the prize fighter, Kevin Owens.
I like him both ways, so it doesn't matter what to me, heel or face, I'm going to love him either way, and I always have. I met him when he was in Ring of Honor. I mean, I was at the Ring of Honor show when he was not allowed in the arena, and he picked up the microphone outside the arena and started cutting a promo for like 20 minutes. Just sitting there, him in a microphone, like 9,000 people outside New York City. And he's just saying that kind of promo, saying, I'm going to get back in the ring. I'm going to get that El Generico. I'm going to become the ROH champion because I'm Mr. Wrestling. And that's just who he is. He's just that awesome. Why is he in the mid-card? I have no idea. But he needs to get back into the title hunt. He really does.
I got to ask you, do you remember the final battle Ring of Honor event in 2010?
I was there.
I believe that's the night that where Tyler Black lost the title to Roddy Strong.
Yeah.
No, Roderick Strong defended the title against Davey Richards.
Right. I was at that show. That's the show when El Generico supposedly ended Kevin Owens' ROH career. And they fought all over the arena, and there was everything you could possibly think of. And the kid got involved, and everybody got involved, and it was a I have the show. It was a fantastic night. I was there.
Oh, it was Glory of Honor where Tyler Black lost the title.
Yes, I was at that one also.
Yeah, it was at the Manhattan Center.
Yep, I was at both.
Yep, yeah. The main event was Roderick Strong versus Tyler Black for the Ring of Honor Championship in a no disqualification match.
Amazing match. I know because I was there.
I'm looking at the card. I mean, the card looks so fun. I mean, you got Claudio teaming up with Chris Hero, beating the world's greatest tag team.
An amazing, amazing show.
And even Christopher Daniels versus Austin Aries.
A phenomenal match. I know because I have the DVD.
Yeah, dude, I'm telling you, Ring of Honor is so massively underrated. Especially
Ring of Honor, it was amazing.
Yeah, I mean, again, when it comes to Ring of Honor, you've been watching it since 2002.
Yeah,
when it first emerged.
I discovered in 2003, actually. I love that. I love the old Ring of Honor. This one I can't stand.
When I come visit you, I need to watch the DVDs again. I mean, I've seen some of them, but I think I got to watch the DVDs with you, Mark.
I have over 65 of them from Ring of Honor, so. So be my guest. You can dip into the collection all you want, pal.
Well, you know what? Since you're the Ring of Honor expert, I mean, I'm going to be following your lead because that's how I did with my other friend, who's a Ring of Honor guy like you. It's about learning from the guy that's been watching it since the beginning.
You've seen the movie list that I have, so you know what's on. The collection's yours, my friend. Be my guest. So
all right. That's why I love you, Mark.
Love you too. But let's get back to the Rumble.
Yeah, let's get back to. back to the programming. Let's start off with the women's Royal Rumble match, because we always go ladies first.
Let's do it.
Well, so far from what I see is, you know, Bayley, obviously Bayley, along with Nia Jax, Becky Lynch, Bianca Belair, Ivy Nile, and Maxine Dupri are the competitors so far.
They're the heavy favorites, yeah.
Bayley's obviously got to be considered the odds-on favorite.
Bayley's been the odds-on favorite for the past 2 years,
right?
At least, if not three. And then they always pull a swerve. Everybody remembers 222, Ronda Rousey. We don't talk about that ever.
you see, every time I think about that, I'm telling you, Rick, I mean, our friend Ricky, he called me, and we had a meeting. We got to tell the story again, because we have to remind everybody just how bad we all three of us were affected. We had a meeting. Neither, all three of us, we had never seen each other so angry as educated, knowledgeable, and passionate wrestling fans. We were furious.
I knew when Bayley got eliminated in 222, and then they brought out Ronda Rousey. I screamed, she's gonna win, and I was not happy about it. Yeah. As a matter of fact, I punched the wall. I was so angry. And then
I think Ricky did too, or at least he wanted to punch the wall.
No, Ricky was very upset, and so you were furious.
I mean, I was so furious that in the meeting, this particular hat, I picked it up and I threw it. So I kind of desecrated a Star Wars hat. I mean, I'm a certified Star Wars nerd, so I kind of basically, I did something bad.
Yeah, you turned Sith for about 10 minutes. It happens.
Okay, well, who knows? I haven't been a Sith. Who knows? Well, how do you know I haven't been a Sith for a long time? But anyway, I got to be honest. Well, this Rumble match, now, Becky Lynch is obviously a favorite. Now, Becky Lynch has won it before.
Yes.
Except we want to see her this time win it as a babyface.
Becky does not need the Rumble win.
I wish I could say Asuka, but you know, Asuka won it back in 2018. We all saw how that ended up, and of course, I'm a big fan of Asuka, and I really want to see if she have her main event run and this time do it right. But
well, Asuka's kind of gone down a little bit. She's
unfortunately
she's done some amazing work, and unfortunately, Asuka's career is just. That's why I think she had to join Damage Control to get her uplifted a little bit.
Yeah,
but they are pushing Bayley very, very hard to win the Rumble, and I think she has to win it. It's the one thing in her career she has never ever done, and she's never she defended with the world title at WrestleMania 33, came out the winner, phenomenal four way dance match. She won Money in the Bank. She won NXT. I was there when she won the NXT title here in Brooklyn. She's done it all. She's never won the Rumble, and now's the time.
Now's the time, yes.
If she doesn't win the Rumble, her credibility, I hate to say it because I love Bayley, but if she doesn't win the Royal Rumble this year, credibility, shot, gone, goodbye.
If she wins the Rumble, does this officially start another babyface run for Bayley?
I think so. I think if she wins the Rumble, we were saying this that she needed to turn face months ago.
Right.
And if you watch
Survivor Series, yeah.
After Survivor Series, after December, we thought she was going to turn. When she comes out, the crowd goes nuts. There are signs, Bella, we love you. Bring back Hugger. Let's not do that, but let's not ever do that again, please. But there are signs, Bella, we love you. Even the kids are starting to root for Bayley now. It's time to have Bayley win the Rumble and get her back to being a face.
And the way to do it, she needs to be entry number one. She needs to win it as the first entrant.
I don't think she needs to be number one and win the whole thing, but I think that she needs a mid number would be fine. Maybe a number 30, not maybe number 30, but she needs to win the thing. She actually needs to win this.
She does. I'm sorry, go ahead.
No question about it. Bayley needs to win this, and I'm picking Bayley to win the Royal Rumble.
Okay. I expect Liv Morgan to make her return.
Yes.
I'm also thinking, I mean, we all know Raquel Rodriguez. I mean, she's been dealing with some sort of illness. She made the announcement not long ago, so I don't think she's going to return for this one. She may or she may not. I mean, I don't know. I haven't seen any update. I mean, obviously, you know, when I saw that, I mean, it devastated me because Raquel Rodriguez is such an amazing wrestler.
Absolutely amazing talent.
Obviously, well, for me personally, aside from Asuka, I would love if Natty won and had a main event run. I would love that, but I think where she is in her career, she's mainly just, you know, working with the other wrestlers, you know, putting other talent over. I mean, she's really just doing what a well-respected pro wrestling veteran does. So she's doing what's best for business. So now if she competes in the match, has a couple of eliminations, lasts a while, okay, that's actually fine. As long as they book her well in the Rumble, then I'm okay with it. But I would expect Tegan Nox also to be part of it.
She will be.
And speaking of Tegan Nox, I'll never forget when she made that announcement, how people were body shaming her. That actually made me mad because I'm sure that like you, I've been a victim of that. So I sent out a shout out to Tegan Nox and said, you know, don't listen to the haters. They're just jealous. And of course, they're too scared to say it to your face. They'll say it behind their phone or their computer. But I would expect, I think Liv Morgan coming back may happen, but I think at this point, Bailey's the favorite, but, you know, I would expect maybe a couple of surprise returns as well.
I think so. And there are a lot of rumors that some wrestlers are leaving different companies to come back to WWE. I think that there's going to be some veterans coming in at the time. Usually it's one of the Bellas. Usually it's Lita. Usually it's Trish. So we'll see. But it's going to be an interesting Royal Rumble. I'm looking forward to it, and I really believe Bailey's finally going to take it.
Okay, all right.
I really do. But I will say this: if somebody damage control wins it, cool. But if Liv Morgan wins it, I think the place is going to go nuts. If she comes back and wins, I think the place is going to go crazy.
Yeah.
But that's just me. But
because it would make sense, because remember, Liv Morgan with the injury, if Rhea Ripley was involved in the story, so if Liv Morgan came back and won it and becomes champion at WrestleMania, then it makes sense.
Yes, it does.
But we have to wait and see. So now we get to the Men's Royal Rumble.
This is a little too obvious, so we know who's going to win this thing.
All right, then who's your favorite? Then who do you think is going to win it?
We know it's one of two people.
Cody Rhodes or CM Punk?
CM Punk or?
Randy Orton, okay.
Cody won it last year.
Right.
At number 30, he won it last year, by the way. Great win. Crowd loved it. Went to WrestleMania. Unfortunately, didn't get the job done because of politics. CM Punk purposely came back WWE for one reason only, to finally main event WrestleMania, and that's where they're pushing him. And Randy Orton's already won this thing. Randy Orton's already won the Royal Rumble. So I'm going to say
twice.
Twice, yes.
Yeah. So 2009 and 2017.
Yep. I'm going to say this. CM Punk has to win the Rumble.
Okay.
I'm going to say Punk wins the Rumble, goes to Mania, and finally goes to Mania and takes the belt off the Tribal Chief. Anybody but The Rock.
Well, there's another talking point we'll have to get to. But I think, okay, my pick is Cody, but I tell you what, CM Punk does great in the Rumble, but do you know who causes him to be eliminated?
I think it's
Seth Rollins, because we all know like that heat between the two. So if Seth Rollins causes the elimination of CM Punk and that builds up their match. See, okay, here's how I'm picturing it now. That's how it goes. It builds up the match. Rollins drops the belt to CM Punk at WrestleMania, but after the match, they shake hands and they put aside their differences. They shake hands and CM Punk says, "Get well soon. I'll be here when you get back. I'll be here when and if you get back, if you come back." And then Seth Rollins says, "I look forward to it."
The man that said, the man who once said the grass greener on the other side, 2-for-1 special, huh?
Right. I mean, you see, well, when you're a wrestling fan like we are, like we kind of understand, like, you know, so we always make these suggestions and storylines, but of course, I'm sure WWE Creative could care less about what we think. Like, oh, they're just fans. If they don't like it, they can go away. But
yeah, but
just the way I see it now. If I think now, I kind of understand why Cody didn't win it last year, because he comes back from an injury. We always say you can't rush somebody to putting the belts on them. It has to be built. So I think it makes more sense. Cody wins it again and then comes back after Roman Reigns and says, you know what? I'm bigger, I'm better, and stronger than ever, Tribal Chief. So it's going to take more than your army to defeat me. So this time, Cody is more over as a babyface than he was last year. He wins it, and this time it's proper for him to get the job done.
Okay, a couple things. One, I'm going to apologize for all the yawning. I'm sorry. I had a bit of a rough night. That's number one.
Me too, dude.
Number two. Well, you and I've been battling a couple personal problems right now.
Wow.
Number one, I don't think Cody wins it because he won it last year. I don't really like repeat champ. I don't really like repeat winners. That's just me personally. Number two, you have to be able to sell out WrestleMania. And if we have the rematch, we all know, I don't think rematches don't work. Hello, Rock and Cena. One and two, both were horrible. One wasn't that good, and two was just freaking horrible. We don't like repeat matches at WrestleMania. So, although Taker and Shawn work, but that's Taker and Shawn. That's a whole different level.
Right.
I think CM Punk has to win because you have to be able to put people to say, I'm going to WrestleMania, and I want to see Punk take the belt off Roman, or RKO could take the belt off him. Either way, Roman's in a lot of trouble. And I think CM Punk came back just specifically to main event WrestleMania, and now's the time. Don't wait a year.
Imagine this. Because I still believe, like, we may see Jimmy versus Jay at WrestleMania. Could you imagine if Jay Uso, like, imagine, like, Cody, like, is battling, and then, like, all of a sudden, like, let's say Cody gets, you know, spiked by, forgot his, I swear to God, what's his name? My mind just went blank.
Oh.
Jesus, this is embarrassing. Yeah. Roman Reigns' cousin.
Oh, Solo.
Solo. See, this is embarrassing. Imagine Solo once again gives the Samoan Spike to Cody, and Roman Reigns is like smiling. He's about to pin him like it was the previous year. Then all of a sudden, out of nowhere, Jey Uso comes in, makes the save, takes out everybody, and then it helps. I mean, that would actually be good. And then he sticks it to the Bloodline and says, you started it, I ended it.
Well, there are members of the Bloodline that are in the Royal Rumble. So what if they pull an Evolution? When Batista won the Royal Rumble, looking Triple H, what year are dead men?
Right.
What about that one? It's
anything's possible, yeah.
And I want to make something else a point to you. So when you said we're just fans, think about it this way. Our What If series, which we started months ago, and we're still working on it, we got over 100 plus hits because of one concept that nobody would have figured out. So we're not just fans. We are people who sit down and actually think about what companies have done wrong, and then we put it out, like our What If series, which we will be continuing later on anyway. But
you want to tell the fans what we got planned?
We are having What If No Monday Night Raw, and we are having what if some other special. What if there are some other feuds that didn't take place? And Alex and I are working on that as well. Yeah, so
definitely,
we have a lot of what ifs coming on, and we're gonna have a lot of fun with it. Yeah. But
I mean, imagine, folks, what if there were no Monday Night War?
Right, exactly. Where would ECW be? But that's a whole different story. But a whole
different story.
So let's talk about the men's world. Let's talk about the men and the women who have won at number one, and there have been several of them. The first one, of course, was HBK back in 1995, but we don't talk about that Rumble ever. Next on,
especially the finish.
Oh, it's terrible.
I mean, I often wondered, like, I think that's the way it was supposed to go. He had to make sure one foot hit the floor.
Right. It was exciting, but the Rumble was like 1 minute, and the match was terrible, except for Bret Hart and Diesel. The rest of it was terrible. Yeah, Benoit in 04, when he eliminated the Giant or the Big Show, Edge in 221, and last year, first woman to ever do it, Rhea Ripley. She wins at number 20. She won it last year at number one, went coast to coast, and she wound up being with Liv Morgan at the end, who drew number two. Number 30s, we know the first one ever do it, the Dead Man, the Undertaker himself, right here, Madison Square Garden, New York City, 2007.
Oh, that Rumble was actually in San Antonio.
You're right. That was in your backyard. I apologize.
My backyard. No, I'm in the north. I'm in DFW, dude. It was in HBK's backyard.
Cena actually 08 was here in New York City.
Yeah, one. Yeah, yeah.
I apologize about that one.
Oh, it's okay, buddy.
Thank you. Triple H 216, and then interesting back to back Lesnar, which we want to talk about ever 223. But and then Lesnar 222 and then Cody 223. Winners from number two, the great Rey Mysterio 106 for the late great Eddie Guerrero. And the one we never discussed, 99, Kennedy McMahon. And there's your entire
history. That's actually Guerrero. My favorite Royal Rumble. I've been ripped and new for this, but the 1999 Royal Rumble match is actually one of my favorites.
Why? It was so bad.
It wasn't that bad. I mean, it could have. Yeah, of course, it could always be better. It wasn't that bad.
Watch that show again and tell me if there wasn't a three count in one of the matches.
I just didn't like how Kane eliminated himself.
The botches in that pay-per-view were so bad. People talk about Starrcade 97 and the botch. How many botches were on that pay-per-view?
Oh, the Rumble? We're talking about the chair shots. Yeah, I think the chair shots. There were supposed to be only seven, but I think the Rock. I don't know what happened. Mick Foley did say that the Rock went off script, but I think I don't know what happened. These things happen though.
With Mick Foley's young kids in the audience, that was ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, could you? I've seen the documentary. I mean, his daughter Noelle was bawling. I mean, you can't blame her.
The Intercontinental match, which was a clear three count, the referee said no, it was only a two. He never got his shoulders off the mat. And then the Royal Rumble match itself. May China rest in peace, the first woman to ever enter the Rumble. That was exciting, but the Rumble itself, Vince McMahon sitting on commentary calling the match instead of being in the Rumble. Pathetic.
He's the heel boss. Of course, he takes the easy way out. It's heelish work. But I loved how Vince was on commentary. Like whenever Boss Man or anybody of the heels tries to eliminate Stone Cold, he's like screaming, "Get him over! Get him out! But why? Come on, guys! $100,000!"
But why did Austin go under the bottom rope, throw Vince's ass in the ring, and then throw him over the top rope and get over with?
And then The Rock comes out. Yeah, I know.
Okay, then The Rock comes out and bothers Austin. It was the worst Rumble ever. It was so god-awful, it's not even watchable.
All right, I mean, let's talk a Rumble that was in your backyard, the 2000 Royal Rumble.
One of my personal favorites, loved it.
You were there, by the way, right?
No, I was at Matt's house. I tried to get tickets, we couldn't get them.
Oh, that's right. I think Ricky told. I think you and Ricky tried to go, but unfortunately, because I mean, I imagine tickets must have sold out in like what, 5 minutes.
There were five guys who tried to go to that one: Richard Linkwich, Mark J. Braverman, Matthew Knocht, who's one of my best friends in the world. I forgot two other. I think my Jeff Braverman, he rest in peace, my little brother.
And of course, this episode is dedicated to his memory.
Thank you. And my brother's best friend, Stephen Fuzzy Solomon.
Okay.
You know how many of us wound up going?
None.
We tried to get tickets. We tried everything we could. We couldn't go. So we just all crammed ourselves into Matt's house. We watched it in there, and we were amazed, except for the bikini show, which we don't talk about ever.
Yeah, especially because I'm a lifelong supporter of women's wrestling. So, you know, and I have to congratulate, you know, I just don't understand. I mean, women's wrestling is very important. For so long, they relegated, you know, female talent to doing this bikini stuff like that. I mean, obviously, yep. When I was 10, from when I was 14, obviously I liked it. But, you know, as an adult, you know, I mean, I just basically grew up and understood more. I mean, I got to tell you, I have a lot of heroes in women's wrestling, but one of them is Thunder Rosa. I don't know. I'm not sure if you're familiar with her because you don't follow AEW. You don't watch AEW or follow AEW.
I've heard of her. She's in the role.
She's amazing. She recently had her first singles match since her back injury. I'm telling you, Thunder Rosa is one of my heroes. But I got a lot of heroes in women's wrestling. But I'm glad. We're not talking about that. But I'll go back to the 2000 Royal Rumble. I mean, we all remember the championship. Cactus Jack versus Triple H.
What a match. And of course, we're forgetting one very important match. The table match that started that made the Dudleys and the Hardys who they are today. When Jeff Hardy jumps off the top of the entrance way and smashed one of Dudleys through the table. What a match that was.
Yeah. And then not long after, the Dudleys started putting women through table.
And then, of course, you had the Taz and Kurt Angle's winning undefeated streak. So
yeah, Taz's debut.
Jam-packed show. It really was.
Yeah, it really was, yeah.
Some of the greatest stuff has happened at the Royal Rumble.
It really has. So that's why we got to go, like, you mentioned you don't want The Rock at WrestleMania.
No.
Well, speaking of The Rock, actually, there was actually some news before we actually did this show. Yeah, he's actually been appointed a part of the WWE's TKO group of directors.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Good luck.
And he's also now has the rights to The Rock. He has ownership of The Rock name. I thought he's had that for a long time.
He's had it forever. He's had it forever. That I
think now it's just like it's official. Like he can use it whenever he wants. He gets. I mean, I don't know. But well, I swear, I thought he had it forever.
He has. He even went. I think he even went on. Even on went on a couple of radio shows and said that he owns the name. So there you go.
Of course, you know, there's the news out. WWE Raw is moving to the Netflix stream starting in January of next year.
Yeah, that's a mistake. They're moving to Netflix. I don't understand that one at all. But what's USA going to do on Monday nights now?
Yeah, see, I didn't want to do an episode about the Raw Netflix deal because, you know, again, I mean, this is honestly a thing that can only last like 30 seconds to 2 minutes. So that's why I just mentioned it on this program right now.
Yeah, we can't do a whole episode about that, but I think it's stupid. No,
I can't because, you know, it's, you know, but anyway.
Anyway, all right. So we have Bayley winning the women's. We have CM Punk or you say Cody, I say RKO winning the men's. And we know Roman Reigns walking out with the belt.
Mm-hmm. Well, last thing I want to say about The Rock, if The Rock was the host of WrestleMania, that's actually no problem. I think The Rock being the host of WrestleMania, no problem because The Rock's, you know, The Rock is still entertaining and he always will be. So I think The Rock hosting the event is not too bad. Now, if he was involved in the main event, like if he had a role of an enforcer to make sure that none of the heels interfere, okay. Because let's be honest, at this point in his life and career, does Rock really need to be a champion? He's still a champion. He's always going to be our people's, you know, the people's champion. But you know what I'm saying? Like, does he really need to have the belt put back on? I mean, he's not even a full-time wrestler. It never makes sense with a belt on a part-time wrestler or a guy who just makes appearances every now and then.
Okay, 2 points about this. One, The Rock did this already at the Royal Rumble when he ended CM Punk's long run. It didn't work.
And I'm sure that you're still upset about that.
Yes, we have Rock Cena, which was just terrible back, and I think it was 08. That's number one. Number two, there are certain things that we just don't need anymore. We don't need to see The Rock on WWE TV as an active wrestler. Maybe he could be the referee for the main event. Whomever did it.
Or the the ringside enforcer.
Yes, some like Mike Tyson was. We do not need The Rock in the ring anymore. We just don't. Alex, I think we're a little bit in overtime here, my friend.
No, we're good. No, overtime is usually over an hour. No, we're good. So, but you know, I think at this point we've covered everything. So, yes, so I'm gonna ask you, are you excited about this Royal Rumble?
Yes. I'm excited to watch Bentley finally win it.
I'm just hoping that they don't mess it up, because the last two have just been, oh, man.
And speaking of Bentley, there she is.
Ah, look at that.
I have a ton of her stuff, and that's one of my favorite shirts so far.
Absolutely.
I have a damage control shirt. I have a lot of her stuff.
Well, that's actually going to do it. So, this definitely did not hit overtime, but we did actually end at the right time. So, Mark, anything else you want to say before we get out of here?
Alex, thank you for this show as always. It's been a blast, and it always is a blast. And thank you so much. And if you want to find me, I'm on Facebook. I'm not on Twitter, but I'm on Facebook. I'm on TikTok now. I released my protest from TikTok because that was obvious. I'm also on Instagram. I'm everywhere. You can find me everywhere you want. So, Alex, where in the world can we find you?
Well, you can find me on Twitter. You can find me on Instagram. You know, just look for the Bear of Texas. But also, you can find this show anywhere you get your podcast. Just so everybody knows, you know, if you look in the description, I am starting to gladly accept donations. But just keep in mind, it's not mandatory. It's totally up to you. You'll find my Cash App. You'll find Venmo. You can even send me super thanks through YouTube. But again, it's totally, entirely up to y'all. No worries at all. Because again, what means more to me than anything is the love and support, and y'all have been doing a good job. Mark, thank you again for coming on. Ladies and gentlemen, don't forget to hit the like and the subscribe button. Also hit the notification bell so you don't miss out on anything, because Mark and I will be back to recap the Royal Rumble, and you can bet on that.
Yes, we will. Good night, everybody. Thank you so much.